Gonna build a mountain from a little hill.
Hey guys, and thank you so much for tuning into my channel. My name is The Lady Designer, and we're here with the Safari Boat Ride final episode, or final speed build, where we're going to build the station, a queue line, a path leading towards the entrance of the zoo, and the last habitat for our Safari Boat Ride. Now, I actually almost forgot, but a few months ago, you all suggested names for this zoo, aka for the ride, and we also did a poll on the community wall to vote for your favorite name. And the winning name was River Safari Adventure, and I have actually no idea if I ever spoke about that end result. So, but still, thank you guys so much for voting and for all the name suggestions back then. I really do appreciate it. So yeah, we're going to call this now the River Safari Adventure. but still, also the Safari Boat Ride, because it is a Safari Boat Ride and I just can't make anything else out of it, I guess. But yeah, thank you guys so much for voting and for all the name suggestions back then. I really, really do appreciate it. And also, let me know in the comments down below, who of you were here since the very beginning when we started working on this Safari Boat Ride, aka River Safari Adventure? I'm super excited to hear who of you are such legends for still being around since we ever started this series. So do let me know in the comments down below. So the first thing we're going to build in this episode is the station. I really wanted to use the bamboo for the station because I felt like this is the most fitting. Also, since we used more bamboo around the whole boat ride with other habitats, and it just really has this very nice tropical vibe to it, and I just really, really love that. And despite saying in the last episode that I probably wouldn't make a queue or anything like that, I decided to make a queue anyways and make the connection to the entrance, as I just mentioned. Yeah, since this was actually pretty close and I had the space for it, so I was like, you know what, let's make this feel a little bit like some kind of proper area and not being like only a POV from starting from the station and ending at the station. So it feels a little bit more finished off right now, if I may say so myself. Now, a very, very, very big downside of this whole zoo, it is full with bugs. Apart from a lot of animals escaping all the time without seeing even where they would be able to escape, and of course the sun bears not being able to go from one side to the other side of the water with the climb frames, I really have no idea why that is still not fixed. I have asked Frontier a few times now in 2 months, I think, since when did I had like the early access of the Southeast Asia Animal Pack. Since then, I already have these issues. Yeah, I hate to say it because I love Frontier games a lot, but I'm a little bit disappointed in the speed lately of how they fix bugs or get back to you. I'm not really used to that at Frontier, let's put it that way. So I'm a little bit disappointed in that, to be completely honest. And it's just amazing that it's been taking so long to get back to it. I'm just not used to that for Frontier, so I really hope that is going to change. Maybe they're just super busy with Elite Dangerous now launching, but still, it feels a little bit like Planet Zoo is being less prioritized, which is such a shame because I just really, really love Planet Zoo, and I really do hope that there will be lots of updates and stuff and DLC still coming up. So I really do hope that this is just some kind of temporary setback. I really don't know. Yeah, it's a little bit disappointing to say the least. But anyways, the last bug that I have found in this stage is the fact that I can't open my boat ride because it just says that the entrance and the exit are not connected. Well, you can tell they are really, really, really connected, but for some reason the game doesn't recognize it. So I can't open my boat ride. But the good thing is that I still have it on a testing mode for like a few, ever since I started this boat ride, I think. So yeah, I can at least make the POV, but yeah, it's just really odd that I'm not able to open the Safari Boat Ride itself. So I'm a little bit disappointed about that as well. Now we're finishing up this zoo. I'm actually not entirely sure if I'm going to upload it to the same workshop still, but let me know in the comments down below if you guys want to see this boat ride in the workshop yourself and to be able to work on it or just experience the boat ride yourself as well. Do let me know in the comments down below if you still want that, even though it's broken. But yeah, it's just really, in all honesty, very sad to see that I'm not really able to just finish this to how it should be with a working boat ride, with people in the queue and enjoying the fantastic boat ride that we build. Yeah, that's a little bit sad, but yeah. Other than that, because obviously it's not all negative, I'm really, really, really happy that we're finally finishing this series. And I asked you all in the latest episode, like, what animal you wanted to see the most for the last animal, and most of you agreed of the Derpy Bungo phase. So of course we're going to add the Derpy Bungo phase as the last animal. I think it's a perfect fit, perfect match for the last habitat. And it's just, it's kind of a little bit like the mascot of our channel right now. So it all makes sense to add the Derpy Bungo phase, my favorite animal of the game. And so we will. But first, we need to finish the station itself. So the station as a set will be made out of a lot of bamboo. I'm also using a lot of rope pieces to make it look a little bit more realistic. And on both sides of the station, there will be a lot of tropical plants and trees to really make it all blend in more into the tropical environment around it. And the station will also be decorated with some vines. You may have seen me placing them around already a few times. And I think those vines just really are the finishing touch to make this all look a little bit more tropical in the end. So we also made sure that the connection in between the station and the capuchin monkey habitat was filled and all looked nicely with a lot of rocks, tropical trees and plants. And of course, also behind the capuchin monkey habitat, there was a lot of emptiness. So I also had to fill that one up with mostly just rocks, because I really wanted to make sure that the capuchin monkey was not able to escape and jump from the islands that they have to the backside of their habitat. And after that, it was time to start filling in the area around the path, going from the station towards the entrance of the zoo. I did keep this very simple with just some tropical rocks and some tropical plants and trees. And the bungo habitat is getting one glass wall for the guests to see the bungos also from the path. For example, when the queue line for the boat ride would be full, well, okay, it's not going to be full in this real zoo, but just pretend that if the queue line would be very full, it would be nice for the guests to be like, oh, you know what, we're just gonna wait and check out the bungos and then we will be able to join the queue line in a later stage. And I actually used glass on purpose because I do know that the bungos can be very stressy as well. So instead of like making an open fence, I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna have one glassy wall on that side. And after that, it was time to fill in the last area for the bungos itself. And I had to make sure, of course, that the bungos were not able to reach the water because else they will be escaping through the station. Something I really wanted to avoid. Also because I don't want to close off the area around this station too much with like the elephant grass. Like, we had to use elephant grass a lot throughout this whole zoo. And sometimes it can be just a little bit too much. And sometimes I had to add a little bit too much just because the animals were still able to escape. So that was kind of a pity, but I think in the end, it still all looks and feels very natural in the end. But I really wanted to avoid that the station, when you approach it, that it would be very full with like a lot of elephant grass and stuff. So I really didn't want that. So make sure that the bungos are not able to reach the water and you are good to go. So the bungo habitat is more raised, so the bungos are not able to reach the water, but still the habitat is low enough for our guests to look into the habitat from the boat ride. And I also made sure that we have some enrichment items more placed on the edges, so the guests will definitely get a good glimpse of the bungos in their habitat. So I did divide the habitat a little bit with some tropical rocks in the middle of the habitat. So you would not really see the glass wall from the boat ride, because I feel like that is definitely going to ruin the experience with being in the boat ride itself. So that is why I made sure that there was like this, basically some kind of wall in between one and the other side in the bungo habitat. Other than that, the habitat is pretty plain with just some aquatic rocks and some trees and bushes that mostly fit the wishes of the bungo. I didn't go too crazy tropical or anything like that. I think the bungo was from Africa. I started out myself once I say this, but I just chose the biome and the trees from the bungo that the bungo really likes. So it looks maybe a little bit different than the other habitats, but I'm totally fine with that, to be honest. So this last habitat really made me realize how much I would love to start a new tropical zoo, especially because of the station, which was just a very small thing to do, actually. But I just really enjoy creating these tropical vibe, and especially if there are more structures involved. Which wasn't really something we did too much at this safari boat ride. So yeah, I am really, really excited to start something new again in the future with this tropical theme and less nature, more building, and having this just good combination of both. And I'm actually not really sure if I will start this new zoo right away, because we have probably a new DLC coming up at the end of this month or beginning of July. And yeah, I'm just not really sure if I want to wait for the announcement or when the DLC has dropped. Like, maybe it will have some really, really nice building stuff in it that we could also use for this new zoo. So I'm not entirely sure about that just yet. But I do dare to say that I'm 99% sure that this is going to be a tropical zoo. Whether we start it before the announcement, after the announcement, or when this DLC will drop, we will be starting a new tropical zoo, a real zoo. So not something like Inama Zoo with a Jeep or with this safari boat ride with a boat ride, but real zoo. And we're going to start something tropical. I'm definitely going to do that, but when exactly, that is going to be the question. But yeah, this project really has been a fantastic experience. I really, really did enjoy creating this zoo, or aka boat ride. Please do let me know in the comments down below what was your favorite habitat during this series, and if you're excited for a new DLC that will hopefully be announced at the end of this month. My favorite habitat is really hard, though. I was thinking, like, okay, what would I answer if someone would ask me that question? And I was like, maybe the capuchin monkey, or the dingo, or the hippo, or the dwarf caiman, or the flamingo. I was like, you know what? I really can't choose. I really enjoyed building all these habitats, and I really don't have a favorite. I think all the habitats have a special place in my heart. I mean, I built them myself. So yeah, I'm just curious, what is your favorite habitat that we build throughout this series? Do let me know in the comments down below, of course. And if I am excited about a new DLC, I'm definitely excited about a new DLC, especially if the rumors are true that this is going to be more of a pack with some new building stuff. I really am. I love the creative side of the game, but I also love new animals, of course, but I do really like the mixture of that. So the Southeast Asia animal pack was not entirely my thing. Like, I like the animals, but they're also not really my favorite animals, but it was just a good pack. But I really do enjoy having a pack with new pieces and some things that can trigger me and inspire me to do a lot more different things and a lot more other things in the game as well. So yeah, I'm just hoping for a good combination of new stuff together with some new animals, and hopefully they're gonna be super awesome animals. Like I said in the previous episode, there are some leaks out there. So it's probably going to be an African DLC. I'm not going to spoil the animals, because I do know that a lot of people just want to stay surprised. So I'm not going to tell what kind of animals, but you're probably able to read it in the comments somewhere if you are really curious what kind of leaks there are. But I'm still, like, it's not 100% guaranteed, but it's like 95% probably. I don't know. I don't know. We have to wait and see about that, guys. But okay. We're wrapping this video up. Thank you guys so much for your incredible and amazing support throughout this series. Leave a like at the video if you guys enjoyed, and subscribe, of course, if you haven't already. And stay tuned for the on-ride safari zoo tour, POV, whatever we're gonna call it. That is going to be up within now in a week or two. So stay tuned for that. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. And I really hope to see you guys all in the next one. Bye, guys.